children, how are you all? Yes, hope you enjoyed your vacation well. You are waiting for your academics to start. Your new year, new academic year. Yes, I know you all are waiting. Because, to which class you have come now? Class 3. Class 3. Great achievement, children. You passed class 2. Now you are in class 3. Come on, first let us clap for ourselves. Yes, clap. Very good. Yes. And you know, you have many interesting stories in your English textbook. Do you know that? Yes. You like stories, isn't it? Everybody likes stories. Even I too like stories. So, in this year, we have so many interesting stories for you, many grammar topics for you, and you will enjoy each and every lesson a lot, children. Okay, so let us go to the first lesson. Before we go to the first lesson in our class 3 textbook, do you want to see your textbook? Yes, I will show you. This is your class 3 textbook, children. Okay, very colorful, isn't it? You like it? Very good. Now, if you open the class 3 textbook, you have a very interesting story at the beginning itself, children, for you. Because you all have come to class 3, no? So the author has given a very, very interesting story. Each and every bit you will enjoy a lot. Okay, so let me tell you the name of the lesson. Shall I tell you, children? Yes? The name of the lesson is, look on the board, The Royal Parade. Come on, read along with me. The Royal Parade. Royal means, you know, very high, very bright. Parade means, you know, yes, before any festival, when a festival is taking place, all the animals, all the people will be going, right, in the streets, walking through the streets with large trumpets and drums, you know, particularly during Ganesha. How we take Ganesha statue, children? Everybody will be dancing and Ganesha will be moving in one lorry or in one auto, and you people will be dancing before it, and there will be lot of sounds, and people will be there before it, after it, you know, that is called as parade. Okay, now see at this picture, this is the parade. Can you see a elephant is there? Okay, and you can see people before and after, they're all going in streets, they're all going in streets, animals. And you can also see some dancers, some devotees, and some people very grandly going in one lane. So it is called parade. Now, let us go with this lesson called Royal Parade. And you know, when this Royal Parade takes place? Yes, it takes place during festivals. Just like our Ganesha festival. At the time we put the statue in water, how we take Ganesha statue? In the lanes, in the same way, when there is a grand festival, this parade will take place where many people will be walking in a street. Now, let us go with the lesson. And before going in the lesson, before going to lesson, let me tell you, before, now only people are going, right? We see only people going, but in past times, in earlier days, very long ago, animals like camels, horses, people, kings, queens, all these people used to go in a parade. Okay, now let us go what is with the story of the Royal Parade. And in this story, please look at the word, the keywords. These are the main words in the story, children. If you keep all these words in the mind, story will easily come to your mind at the time of exam. So this is just like key points that you need to remember to have the whole story in your mind. Okay, please look at, focus at the board. Nagar Hall, it's the name of the place. Parade, Jaya, Nagar Hall, N-A-G-E-R-H-O-L-E. Parade, P-A-R-A-D-E. D-E, parade. Jaya, J-A-Y-A. Deva, D-E-V-A. Dasara, D-A-S-A-R-A. Mysuru, now called as Mysore, but in our lesson, this word is there. So, you have to keep this word in your mind. M-Y-S-U-R-U. Royal, R-O-Y-A-L. Calf, C-A-L-F. You know what a calf is, children? A baby elephant is called calf. Herbal, H-E-R-B-A-L. H-E-R-B-A-L. So, these words you have to keep in mind so that you can recollect whenever during exams. If you know all these words, you can write the story. Okay. Now, let's go into the story. I will narrate you. I will tell you what is the story of Royal Parade. So, long before, in the year 1600s, there is a place called Nagarhole. Nagarhole is nothing but it is in Karnataka. And in that place, there used to be a girl called Jaya. And one day, she went to the forest to get a pot of water. So when she came back to get the pot of water, she used to play with a small baby elephant, small calf. What is the name of it? Deva. So the girl and the Deva were best friends. So she used to go to get water with a pot and Deva used to come there. Both used to play whole day together. So what happened? They used to spend lot of time. How the girl used to play with elephant, you know? They used to sprinkle water at each other. You know how sprinkling water? The girl used to sprinkle water with hand and the elephant used to sprinkle water with the trunk. You know the trunk? The trunk of the elephant, long nose. So like that they used to play. Then one day the girl said to Deva, Deva, today I want to go home fast because my father is coming home after 1 week. So today I cannot play with you. I want to reach home fast. So Deva was very happy to see her friend happily going home. And Deva's father was the head of a tribe. Tribe means, you know, a small group living at one place. He was a headman, just like a king of that place. As I told you, this girl's, Jaya's father is a king of small tribe. So what he did? He know everything about herbal medicines. He know how to prepare medicines with herbs. You know what are herbs, children? Yes, plants. From plants we make medicines. Long before, we have no medicines, children. There are no tablets, no syrups, what we are using. All that were not there. Then how people used to treat the patients, you know? With the help of herbs, plants. They used to take the leaves from the forest and different leaves are used for treatment of different diseases. This girl's father knew about the herbal medicines. The king of Mysore asked the girl's father, Jaya's father, to come to Mysuru as he was preparing some medicines. The girl's father went there with some honey and some herbs to meet the king. And after 1 week, he was returning back. So the girl was very happy. The girl wanted to meet her father after 1 week. And she also asked her father to bring Mysore Pak from Mysuru. What is it? Mysore Pak. She promised her friend Deva, I will get you some Mysore Pak. She said to the calf. And the calf was very happy. Then the girl went back with a pot of water on her head to her village. When she reached her village, you know what happened? By the time, many people were there before her house. And she saw the people and she came to know that her father came back. And she was very happy that she is going to meet her father after a week. We also want, when we miss our father, no? When our father goes somewhere, we want to meet him, we want to talk to him. Right? In the same way, the girl was also very happy. So she put the water in one trough, in one open container for the animals to drink. and she went to her father. Then her father saw her with a broad smile and took the girl and put her on his lap. You know, you also sit on your father's lap, right? In the same way, the girl also sat on her father's lap. And her father was speaking to the villagers. What was he telling, you know? He was telling about the royal palace, the king of Mysuru, the throne made up of gold. You know what is a throne? The seat where the king sits. Telugu, what do we call? Simhasanam. You know that, no? So he was telling about the throne, the big streets, and the royal king, the dancers there, the palace there, and all the villagers were listening to the girl's father, and they were having their Mysore Pak also. Father brought Mysore Pak for the whole village tribe. After hearing all this, what did the girl feel? She wanted to go and see all that. So she asked her father, Dad, I want to see the parade. I want to see how the palace is. And there is going to be a big festival called Dasara. At the time of Dasara, there will be a grand parade with animals, dancers, military officers. This girl was very interested. So she asked, please take me, Dad. I want to see that. But father said, no, you are very small. You cannot walk long distance. This time for Dasara festival, I am going to take your brother. Next year I will take you, he told to the little girl. And she was disappointed. Yes, we will be disappointed if anyone says no. And in those days, children, there was no transport like bus, car, auto, that all were not available. People used to go by only walk. You can understand from the lesson. That's why father said, you can't walk, my dear child. It is very long. Mysore is very long. This year I will take your brother. Next year I will take you. So the girl was disappointed. She went to forest. And she went to her friend. What is her friend's name? The baby calf, Deva. She went to Deva and she put her hands around the trunk of Deva and said, I too want to go to Mysuru. My father is not taking me. He says that I am very small to walk a lot of distance. Then you know what the Deva did? It took the baby on the back of it and started walking. And the girl did not understand. Deva, stop. Where are you going? Stop, stop. She was shouting in the ears of the elephant. But the Deva was not listening. It was going, just taking the girl into the open fields. It started walking out of the forest. And the girl was afraid. Because it is not safe for the animals to come out of the forest. They may be caught by the people. So she was afraid that her friend might be in trouble. So she said, no, Deva, go back into the forest. But it was just moving, moving, moving. And it reached one place where many people were there. And there, you know who was there? A lady, a royally dressed lady. The queen was there. The Mysuru queen. The queen of Mysuru was there in her chariot. You know what is a chariot? Yes, a long carriage where royal people use for transport. You call it Rabam in Telugu. Okay, in the olden days, kings and queens used to go in that. Like that, she started going. Please look at the spelling. Chariot. Chariot is nothing but a royal carriage. A royal transport used by kings and queens in those days, in olden days. She was waiting there and she saw this elephant. She was very happy. She said, what a majestic, what a fantastic elephant. I want this elephant at any cost, she said. But our girl, little girl Jaya was very upset. She was afraid. She said, no, I won't give my elephant to you. It belongs to forest. But the queen said, my dear little girl, give me your friend for the royal parade of Dasara. For Dasara, we have a jumbo parade, elephant parade. For that, I want your elephant. It is looking very beautiful. I promise you that once the parade is over, I will send your Deva to your forest. After listening to these words, Jaya felt reassured. Jaya felt that yes, they are going to send back. She thought that now Deva is in safe hands. So she said, okay, I will send my elephant. But Deva will be alone there. There will be no friends for my Deva, for my elephant, she said. Then the royal lady, the queen said, "You also can come with your elephant. I can see both of you are very good friends." The girl was very happy. She wanted to go for Dasara ride. So she said, "I will come, but I'm too small." Then the queen said, "Okay, I know that you're very small. You cannot take care of yourself. You can bring any other with you." Then the girl said, "I have three more with me. Can I bring them along with me?" Who are those three children? Mother, father, and her brother, obviously, right? So she wanted to take her family to Dasara along with Deva. Then the queen said, "You are welcome, my dear child, and you are the guests of King of Mysuru." In that way, all of them reached the palace, and there was a great parade, and everybody enjoyed the march. You know, march means the marching in the streets, this kind of marching. Okay, you march. In the same way, a royal marching took place in the festival, and in that, who participated? Our Deva, the majestic elephant, participated, and everyone enjoyed the stylish walk of the elephant, and the girl and the family also were a part of the Dasara festival. In this way, she could see the grand royal parade of Dasara. Did you understand the summary? Now let us have a graphic presentation of this lesson. Now please watch the video, children.
The Royal Parade by Nandini Nayyar. One day in the late summer of 1638, the sun was rising over the thick forest in Nagarhole. Jaya bathed and filled her pot from the Kabrini River. As she walked home in her wet pavadai satti, she called out to Deva cheerfully,
"Deva!"
Deva, the elephant calf, hopped out of the thicket. On other days, Jaya and Deva would play in the river, splashing about and spraying water at each other. But today, Jaya held Deva's trunk and said,
"Deva, today Appa might return from Mysuru. I'm going to run home."
Jaya's father was the chief of the biggest tribe in Nagarhole. The king of Mysuru had sent his guard to the forest to summon him. The king wanted advice on herbal medicines. Jaya's father had taken special herbs and honey to the royal court a week ago.
"I'll bring you some Mysore pak,"
Jaya hoped her father had remembered to keep his promise about the sweet. Deva trumpeted happily as he saw his little friend hurrying home, balancing the pots on her head. When Jaya neared her home, she saw people crowding there.
"Ah! Appa is already home," she said.
She poured the water from the pots into the cleaned trough in the cow shed and ran into the hut. The cows mooed and walked to the fresh water. Jaya's father lifted her up and seated her on his lap with a big smile. He was telling the people from his tribe about Mysuru, the new king there, the magnificent palace, a throne made of pure gold, the wide roads, the crowded markets where everything was available, and the huge temples. He said the city was getting ready for a big festival called Dasara. He said,
"During the festival, the king himself leads a grand parade of royal deities, noble families, military officers, soldiers, dancers, camels, horses, and elephants."
The people listened in wonder as they sucked at their Mysore pak.
"Please take me to Mysuru, Appa," Jaya said.
"It is very far, daughter. Your legs are too small for the long journey. This year I'll take your brother for Dasara,"
said her father, patting her head affectionately. Jaya jumped out of his lap and darted into the forest. Deva snorted joyfully on seeing his best friend again. Jaya ran to him and buried her face in his trunk, sobbing,
"I can walk too, Deva. You know that. But Appa will only take my brother to Mysuru. I too want to see the Dasara parade."
Deva wrapped his trunk around Jaya and lifted her. Placing her gently on his back, He began to run towards the open field. Jaya knew this was not safe for Deva.
"Stop, Deva!"
she yelled. But Deva burst out of the trees and ran across the field. Jaya was shocked to see that the field was teeming with people and elephants.
"Deva, turn back!"
Jaya pulled his ears, but Deva was in no mood to listen. He finally stopped in front of a chariot.
"This is a very majestic elephant calf," said a finely dressed young woman in the chariot.
Jaya soon learnt that people had come from the Mysuru palace to select elephants for the Jambusavari, the elephant parade at the Dasara.
"Turn back, Deva!"
Jaya fearfully shouted into Deva's large ears. Deva shook his head. He took one step forward.
"Little miss," said the woman in a happy voice to Jaya, "can your Deva come for the royal parade?"
Jaya was very scared for Deva.
"No!"
she shouted boldly.
"He belongs here, in the forest."
"Of course, he will return to the forest after the parade. I promise." The woman's voice was reassuring. Jaya felt Deva was in safe hands. Also, she was so proud for her Deva.
"But Deva won't have any friend in Mysuru,"
said Jaya after some thought.
"Surely he will have you. I can see how close you both are. In fact, you can teach him the royal march."
"Me?"
wondered little Jaya.
"Yes. Why don't you bring someone along? You are too young to take care of yourself," smiled the woman.
"Can I bring three someones?"
asked Jaya playfully.
"Definitely. And tell them they are the guests of the King of Mysuru."
That's how Jaya went to see the lights and the fireworks of the great Dasara festival in Mysuru, with her brother and parents. The graceful dancers, the smart soldiers, the brilliant band, the brightly decorated elephants, camels and horses were all very fascinating. But Deva was the most elegant of all, and it was for Deva that Jaya and her brother cheered the loudest.